Richard Southern joins us from the home office for a look at the top business stories. Hi, Richard.
Hey, Janella, welcome back. Good to see you.
Thanks so much. Good to see you. So let's begin with a big day on Wall Street.
You know who rang the opening bell at the New York Stock Exchange, Janella?
Who's that?
Andrew Cuomo, the New York governor. He had a mask on, but there he was ringing the opening bell today. And for good reason, Cuomo there doing the honors because traders returned to the floor of the iconic New York Stock Exchange for the first time in 2 months. Only 25% of the exchange's traders were on the floor. They all had to get their temperatures checked. But very much a symbolic, you know, getting back to business there at the NYSE today. And you know what happened? Stocks rallied on signs that global economies are crawling back from the pandemic shutdown. There's fresh optimism about a potential vaccine. And so the Dow was up more than 500 points. Wall Street's back to where it was in early March. It's almost recouped all of the losses seen during COVID-19. TSX, it was higher today, still down about 10% on the year, but things looking better. Janella, traders were buying some of the stocks most beaten up during the last month, like Carnival Cruise Lines, which was way up today, Air Canada and American Airlines. So things looking better on the stock markets here.
Okay, well, meanwhile, here at home, the big Canadian banks say their earnings have taken a nosedive due to the pandemic.
Yeah, so the banks are starting to report earnings, and it gives us a sense of the financial toll COVID-19 is taking. Scotiabank got the ball rolling on that, and Scotia said earnings down 41% in the last 3 months. Scotia said it had to set aside $1.8 billion to cover bad loans.
Wow.
The bank said that 300,000 of its customers applied for some sort of financial relief on the money it owes Scotia. That includes some mortgage deferrals. We had some troubling comments in for the bank CEO, Brian Porter. Take a look at this. Bank CEO says, quote, "This is not a garden variety recession. We've never been through this before. The banking sector," he says, "will be picking up the eggshells for a number of quarters here." But even with all that, Janella, what happened? Investors bought the stock in the company. Scotia was up more than 7% today. It's kind of like, forget about what's happened. We're looking ahead and we think things are going to get better.
Well, buy low, sell high, right? So
that's the thing, absolutely.
Some folks are taking advantage of that. Okay, some not so good news for Porter Airlines and maybe your travel plans. They're keeping their planes grounded for how long, Richard?
Until July 29th, so basically right into August, it would look like here, Janella. This is the second time Porter has pushed back their resumption of services. And they're kind of talking about how it's tough for them with the border being closed. I mean, this is a private company, so we don't know the financial details. But we suspect that Porter makes a lot of its money flying people, you know, many times a day from Toronto to New York LaGuardia, to Boston Logan. That really can't happen right now. And so the airline opting just to keep all its planes on the ground. We don't know the financial toll this is taking, but we'll have to see. I mean, this is really affecting airlines, and certainly Porter, having not operated a single flight since March, might be more affected than the rest of them. Janella, you and I are back just after 6:30, looking at some more interesting stories, including a historic launch set from the Kennedy Space Center for tomorrow afternoon. We'll be talking about that after 6:30.
Okay, Richard, we'll see you then.
Thanks.